Hello, this is Bern, and if you're confused, if you're anxious, if you don't know if you're being too picky or asking your man for too much, what I'm going to do today on this video is demystify seven principles, seven things you should expect of a man if he claims to be committed to you. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with ambitious and conscious women how you can attract the man and the relationship you want without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or tricks as a result of being the best and most feminine version of you. Now, many guys claim to want to grow into a long-term potential marriage relationship with you, and in the process of dating, show up in ways that are not really cool. And the reason I'm sharing this right now is because there's a lot of confusion. Sometimes women reach out to me and they feel confused. They think that they're asking for too much, and sometimes they are, and I'm clear to point out when that's the case, but many times they're wanting basic things and they're still doubting if they're asking for too much. So to be clear about who this message refers to, I'm talking about not a guy you just met and are starting to date. I'm talking about a guy who's dated you for some time, who decided to become exclusive with you. He says, yeah, I wanna be your boyfriend, I wanna be your man. And you stop dating other guys. Not only that, but you're doing that not just for fun, right? You're at an age where you want to step into long-term marriage and beyond. So if that's the case, under that type of construct, here's the things you should expect of a man. First thing you should expect is quality time spent together. Too often, guys who claim to want to have a long-term relationship with you are too busy to do things, too busy to connect with you, too busy to call you, too busy to see you, too busy to visit you. So almost like they were doing all the hard work, and when you start dating exclusively, they relax and they make other things a much higher priority than the relationship. I'm not sharing that the only priority should be the relationship. That would not be healthy. But to not have the relationship as a high, high priority in their lives, that is something that is not cool if you are exclusive with them. Why? Because by definition, being exclusive means you are not dating any other man. You're closing the doors to your heart and your body and your soul to somebody else who could be taking you to the promised land. Promised land meaning an amazing life of fulfillment and marriage and even children, if that's what you're looking for. So after quality time, the next thing you're looking for is a guy who is consistent in his communication between the times he sees you. Why? Because far too often, you see a guy once a week and then 2 days later, you have no idea where he's coming from. That's okay if that's a guy that you're dating on exclusively, but he's your man. He's the guy that you purportedly want to marry one day, and there's 2-3 days that go by and you don't even know if he's alive or dead. That's not cool. Now, the quality of the communication matters. Why? Because some people, men and women, get lazy and they just send each other a quick little text in the morning, quick text at night. Nothing wrong with that if you want a mediocre relationship. If you want a fulfilling relationship, you have to be willing to spend more time than that, connecting and ideally talking on the phone, seeing each other on FaceTime even better, and making plans to see each other in real life. So communication, I would say daily, if you're growing in a relationship with someone that you want to be long-term, in my mind is very important. Third thing, that you're not asking for too much when you ask him to share his thoughts and his feelings. Why? Because there are men, believe it or not, I know it's be a surprise for you, who when you ask what you're thinking and feeling, look at you like a deer with the headlights on and have no idea what you're talking about, or are unable to express or unwilling to express what they're thinking or feeling. Now, if you want to be happy in a relationship with a man, he doesn't have to be equivalent to your girlfriends who can share endless thoughts for hours and hours of inspiration, chit-chat. But you want a guy who is not a Neanderthal. You want a guy who's able to recognize feelings beyond good, bad, like happiness, sadness, more nuance in his expressiveness, and be able to share with you what the hell's going on. If you're not able to talk to your guy about things that matter, if he's not able to share his feelings and thoughts, then you're always going to be left to your imagination, your stories, and have zero idea about what happens, where to the point where you can be blindsided. One day you wake up and he's no longer your guy because he's not sharing what's in his thoughts and his heart. So be willing to not settle for anything other than a guy who can express what he thinks, what he feels, and when asked the question, what are you thinking, what are you feeling, he can at least digest and share something beyond a grunt, okay? Number four, you need for a guy to be respectful in many different ways. Respectful of your ways of thinking. He doesn't have to agree with your way of thinking, but he does have to be respectful in the way he presents information to you and even in the way he talks to you about his own thoughts and feelings. You want a guy who's able to have a conversation with you about difficult shit without raising his voice and shouting. You want a guy who's not gonna shame you. You want a guy who's gonna appreciate the beauty of you in all your splendor, heart, body, and soul, without wronging you for it or guilting you into eating less or shaming you for wearing anything you want to wear. You want for a guy, he can share his opinions, but ultimately the decision is yours. Next thing he needs to step into is loyalty. And this is one of the things that has to be defined. If you don't define what loyalty means, you will be hurt, even unconsciously. Why? Because for some guys, loyalty is, I will just not make love to another woman. For some guys, it's, I won't make love to another woman or flirt with another woman. For some guys, it's, I won't make love to another woman, flirt with another woman, or have secret conversations via text and email, right? You need to define what is your definition of loyalty, and both human beings need to have the same standard and apply it in the way you connect with people, in the way you react to people, in the way you even like people's shit on Facebook. You need to reach an agreement that is upheld by both parties, so there's no dual standards. 6, consideration with important decisions. He's offered a job somewhere else. Yeah, you're not married, but if he moves away to a different location, that might inhibit your ability to have a real relationship, and you might have to step into long distance. So if something like that happens, that he's able to consider you in the picture, ask you questions about it, and make decisions valuing you, not just that thing, right? So it's not the only important decision that will come to play, but you need to be willing to, he needs to be willing to consider you into the decision-making process for things that matter and that will last and will have an impact on your life and heart. 7, and this is so important, and so many people don't have this and it messes with them and it wastes years. I'm talking about years of women's lives. He needs to have a sense of direction as to where he's going with his own freaking life and where he's taking you in the context of the relationship. So sense of direction specifically in the context of the relationship means he needs to know, does he want marriage? And if so, kind of what does that look like? What's the time frame? If you're someone that's of age of having children and he's interested in that because he has way many more years than you do, he needs to get clear in himself as to what has to happen should you get married for him to be ready to have kids with you, if that's something you're seeking. So a sense of direction, where is he headed? Where does he want to live? What are the things he wants to explore and experience with you? What are things he doesn't want to experience? Because otherwise, you're in a relationship with someone who's a good guy, but you get the feeling that he's never stepping up. You get the feeling that he's never gonna pop the question. You get the feeling, and those are things that should be discussed at some level from early stages, including what are you looking for in a relationship? What are you seeking? What is a time frame that you feel would be ideal for you to step into higher commitment? If the guy has no idea about those things, you, my dear, are playing the Russian roulette. Hope these factors are important enough that you write them down, share in a comment if you want which one you find most important to you. But if you really find this helpful, I'm going to inspire you to go to the first link in the description of this video, click on that link, and be taken immediately to a presentation training that I have for you that's gonna guide you even deeper into how you can create the relationship that you want with a lot less pain than you have in the past. If you find this video is helpful and useful, please click like or thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and last but not least, if you want my help and hand-holding to implement the concepts that I'm sharing here, understanding in full consciousness that learning things and implementing them are two different worlds apart, and you want hand-holding, accountability, and guidance, second link in the description of this video will allow you to have a conversation with me where we can figure out where the best fit to work together and what's the most important area of focus in your life, love life right now. Thank you so much, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.